cool chopsticks, man. Looks just like the real thing. Please. Plastic key. Tastes boring. You know what, kid? Don't do this. Don't do that. Don't listen to me. I'm a bad example. I'll probably be poisoned now because that's not a Lego brand. Yo, dear, would you like some Chachu Bao?
You know it!
Here you go. Got one for you right here. Oh, I'll just take the whole table for you. Here, have some. Eat.
Yum, there. Yum, yum.
Dear, you're looking really terrified. Is that because of these figures that comes with the set?
What?
Yeah, probably. All right, I'm still a little bit sick, but you know, I want to get these videos out for you guys. Thank you so much for joining in. All you new subscribers, welcome. And thank you so much for liking and commenting on my videos. Don't forget to ring that bell for notifications for more videos that will come your way. So look at this. Yeah, it's about time I get back to some city looking stuff. This one though, I'm not quite sure what to think of it, but it kind of looks cool on the front. I like it. This is from a brand called Enlighten. I've done a couple reviews for City Hall. I'll put the card here. Again, I'll put the link in the description if you haven't watched it. They're actually pretty good. And actually you can tell that these are Enlighten brands by looking at the studs. They logo each stud. Yay! How's that for originality? So this is Enlighten's, or which is now known as Q-Man, Golden Chinese Cuisine, which is part of their Colorful City series, number 1137, 796 pieces. Here's the manual, you guys. The manual's actually pretty good. It's really easy to read. If I go through here like this and just show you guys exactly how the manual is. Very nice, very easy. As you can see, this is the lineup for the Colorful City. And I have most of these, except for the vehicles. I do have the school bus. And you know, I'll try reviewing the rest for you guys. But if you want to buy them, or if you're interested in the other sets, just let us know. I'm slowly putting them on the store. We need time to do it. But if you want them like right now, it's available on BrickMeUpScotty.com. Just let us know. Yeah, there they are. The other ones are really small, by the way. And it's just another alternative. Cheaper. Yeah, there you go. Q-Man. 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 Yeah. In case you're wondering, the clutch on Enlighten pieces are actually really tight, which is a good and bad thing. Lego is like perfect, you know? They slot together perfectly fine. But when Tyler was building this with me, he couldn't get the pieces off. He's like, Daddy, help me, I can't pull the pieces off. This thing is super tight, man. In fact, if I do a chop test right now for you guys, which is gonna suck, if I go this high, it probably won't fall apart. Look at that. What fell off? Something fell. It was probably something really small. And yeah, it's all the loose pieces on the inside, like the food and stuff. You see? It's pretty good, man. Yeah. This does look really, really funky, and it almost looks like a Ninjago City type of feel to me, because I have the Ninjago City here, and the docks is completely being taken apart, but we're gonna compare the two together, because maybe this might be more suited for that series, but it's still a cute little set. Like I said, it is really random. So as usual, we will work on the first floor and work our way up. All right, first of all, black base plate. Nothing wrong with that, but it's just dark, man. It looks so dark as a foundation. It's just like the other set that I did, yeah? The little mini cities, the symbol stuff. Anyway, black makes it look really dark to me, but it's okay. You can always switch that out. And just so you know, underneath, if I just tilt it a little bit there, it's not one base plate. It's actually a couple pieces here on this side, like added on there. I don't know why they did that. They could have shifted this whole thing over, put the fire hydrant here on the front, and still be able to put it on one plate. Strange, but it's okay. Let's look at the fire hydrant. Very simple, and you got a stop light there. I'm not sure why they'd want to use a stoplight, but okay. And I got another sign here that says, no parking. Don't park your cars there. It's kind of cool that they did curve it off on the side. You got the window there. It's a little bit scratched up, damn it. I do like how they did the little gray light bricks kind of protruding out a little bit. You got the front main entrance there. There's no door. Why? The floor mat is kind of interesting that they put there. Gold. Maybe they could have moved that out of the way and put a door. But the signs look cool, and those are all stickers. Sorry, man, everything on the set is stickers. And the sign on the top says, Delicious House. That's the name of the restaurant. So on the left, it says, people who come are guests. On the right, it says, people leave like clouds in the sky. You got a window there. The window opens and closes just fine. It's kind of like a takeaway window, except it's not. Maybe that's a regular one, because the one next to it, it's got like an open awning there, and it's got some chashu bao, that's barbecue pork buns. And you got some flowers here on the front. Look at the leaves. I've never seen these before. That looks new to me. They look much, much thicker. They look like they're not gonna break as easy as the ones before. And then above the windows there, there's like a little couple studs that's inside out that kind of makes it look more Asian. It has a little awning there that can tilt up and down. So you got a little side door here. It's nice that they put something there instead of a wall. And just the colors, man, the colors are kind of mixed here. This is like something I would design. It's a little bit funky, but it's okay. You got, at least you got windows that open up here. Yeah. So it's nice that they have a little gap here so you can put your own flowers if you wanted to. Speaking of, I think I'm missing one flower there. Where'd it go? The quick rotation to the back here. Look at that. Yeah, it's all open on the back. Oh man, look at all those studs. I kind of wish they tiled it, but hey, that's okay. Yeah, that's the only thing that sucks, man. This is not modular. You can't take off the second floor. I was like, oh, Enlighten, Q-Man. All you guys had to do was just make this be able to pop off a little easier so I can get my fingers in there. It's really hard to get in there, especially if your kids want to play with it. Might be a little bit tough. Maybe you don't need that. Maybe you're happy the way it is. You come on in, there's a lucky cat. I like the lucky cat. I think that's actually really cool, sitting there on the counter. You got the cashier there, and on the back, it's just like a plain looking calculator. It's real simple. So on the side here where the takeout window is, it's the kitchen area. It's really tight to get in there. I like the stove, and they have a pan on there. Spatula. You know, next to the stove, I'm not quite sure what that is. Mustard? Got a sink there. There's a piece of carrot inside. Next to the sink is the butcher's knife. They have a cutting board there. That's actually pretty funny. And then down below here, they have a cabinet. It's a couple of utensils, fork and knife. I kind of like that look above the butcher's knife. It's kind of hard to see here, but it's like a pane window glass so that, you know, I don't know, it's just a look design thing. I thought that was actually neat, despite it being very simple. Then we come to the table side here, which looks a lot like the Chinese New Year themes that we've seen before. You got a rotating table there. On the back wall, there's another sticker tiled. It's upside down, and that stands for blessing. And they used fence as a partition wall there. And the food sticker looked kind of weak. Look at the chicken, man. That's a terrible drawing. Not sure what the other ones are. Maybe that's mushroom or meatball. And more tasu bao, pork buns. I'm guessing this thing right here is soup. That piece is really loose on top. It just sits on there. So yeah, there you go. That's the first floor. I just wish I could get my hands in there and show you more. Then we come to the second floor. It's an open area where you can eat your food. Got two chairs in there, another table with more pork buns. It's all just a pork bun place, man. I do like the tree here. The tree can be moved how you like it to be moved. It moves very nicely, and this looks a lot like the Ninjago one, or kind of represents that style where it kind of protrudes out. And on top here, I do like the little awnings up here with the trees and a pigeon. Is that a pigeon, right? Bird? Bird's gonna eat your food. Oh, you know what? That pigeon's really good. Pigeon tastes really good in Hong Kong. That should be on the menu. You can put that on the table. Then there's the balcony part here in the middle, and I actually kind of like the design of these pieces that are being slotted in. That's new. I don't think I've seen that before. Have I? Unless I'm getting that old. And then you come to another little balcony here, which is actually pretty secure. It does open and close there. You're not supposed to, but just so you know, yeah, be careful for that piece. It does move. Look at the little fish there, the goldfish. That's pretty funny. You know, you can take the little fish off and put them on your plate too. So this restaurant has more food than you actually needed to know. You can eat cat, pigeon, and fish. And there's another pigeon here on the sign, and this is the same sign that you saw below. I do like the transparent red and yellow that makes it look very Chinese and almost neon-like. So on the inside here though, it is super plain. It's just two chairs and a table. And that could have been a little bit better. You do have this nice sticker painting there, the tree, interesting. And in the middle, there's nothing there but some bamboos, very simple stuff. You come to the rooftop, does have a little hatch here. It doesn't open, it's just like a decoration thing. And you got two little aircon vents. But there is space up here for you to play with your little toys or add more things to it. You know how much I'm a sucker for these kind of signs? It looks like fish balls. Those are fish balls, right? And then bowl of noodles, or maybe they're wonton. I'm not sure, it's orange though. But hey, it's creative. I like that for sure. Now it does come with some figures, and these are very different from your standard figures. Kudos to Enlighten Q-Man, you guys, for actually trying to do something different. Do I like him? Let me show them to you. They're kind of weird. At least it's different. And hey, you're probably gonna use your own minifigures to fill up the set, right? And look at their heads. They're super, super huge. My goodness, they're a little bit too big. So we'll start with the guys first. Look at this guy. He looks like a kid with a drawn mustache. I like the bulldog shirt on him. That's actually a pretty cool print. Look at their hands. Their hands are really different, man. They actually have like finger molds in there, so you know, that's nice. Anyway, his hair looks sleek and pulled back. Printing looks fine, actually, even though the eyes are super big. And this is certainly not. You just look like you own this place, or the restaurant owes you some money. Go in there and collect your money and your food. Then we got this guy who looks like deer, frightened face. Oh no. He's got the bob haircut, and he's the waiter, because look, he's got the menu in his pocket, and he's got the emblem on his shirt and on the back too. Nice printing on this one. Yeah, looks okay. This is Robert Lam, I'm so glad you found my channel too. Hope you don't mind naming you this guy, but you look kind of frantic. Gotta put that food on the table. Well, there you are. Then you got this guy with sunglasses and looks like a star printed behind the sunglasses. Can't really tell. And he's got some printing on there. He looks like a cool dude. He's ready to go in. Maybe find a girl, go on a date. Not sure. And that is Brickzilla. I'm glad you found my channel. Good luck with your channel, man. Really, seriously. Let me know when it's up. I'll check it out. There you are, Brickzilla. Then we got the delivery guy who has a cool helmet, by the way. It functions really well. Opens and closes good. And you can take it off and see the printing on his face. I like his jacket. Same emblem on his chest there and on the back as well. Very cool. I like it. And this is Chandra Marsono. I will review that aircraft cabin really soon. It's from Oxford Block. It's a very, very, very cool set indeed. But there you go. Deliver that food in the meantime. This girl here looks really mean, man. She almost looks scary. She looks like she belongs in a scary film. Besides her freaky red eyes, she has a nice uniform on, printed. Yeah, I just can't stop staring at her face, man. She looks like she wants to kill me. And that is Nikita Wells. There you are, Nikita. Yeah, look at those mean eyes. All right. And you got grandma here. Let's just call her grandma. Yeah, she looks like she's been running the business for a long, long time. I like the printing. I like the little mold that they put next to her lips and the necklace that she's wearing and the red glasses that she has on. It's very cool. Hair looks just fine. Then you got the motorbike that comes with the set, and that looks like any other motorbike we've seen in other sets. Not original or well, but there is a sticker on there, and that's for the delivery boy to take your noodles to you. And then you got this animal creature thing. I just don't like this creature. What is it supposed to be? Is it a kitty cat? What kind of eyes are those? Is it a dog? What is it? Is it a rabbit? I guess they're like, you know what? You can make it whatever you want it to be. This does not belong on the set. Throw this one away and put something else there. You know what time it is, it's Dimension Time. Break out your colorful base plate and you know, you might want to replace this black one with something else. But let's check the width of this thing. Put the plate right there, and that is 16 studs by width. Now let's check out the length. So if I put my 32 base plate here, it is actually 32, 33, 34 studs by length. They added that extra piece at the end. And you know, like I said, it probably could have just fit on one plate. But there you go. Now let's check the height. So break out your 1x4 bricks. Let's put this together. Now I put the chopsticks straight up here. So if you can see that, it is right around 25 bricks in height. There you go. Okay, speaking of dimensions and base plates, one thing is that these sets actually come with these things. These things are cardboard pieces of plates. Man, I don't know. I think they're kind of ugly and they're really in the way. If you're gonna order this from us, I might have to just take this away from you because it will bend, it will crack. My one's already like bent, but you know, you're supposed to just put this down here like that and put it nicely and be like, yeah, look at my road. Yeah, we don't need no base plate. We're just sticking on a piece of cardboard. And just so you know, the other sets actually do come with other plates too, and they kind of combine together, but I don't know if I like that, you know? You're not gonna probably use this at all. So yeah, just so you know, if you're gonna order it, you know, I don't know, go something like that. There you go. So I mentioned, in my opinion, this kind of looks more like a Ninjago theme type thing to me. So I'm gonna pull out the Ninjago city here. Look at that monstrosity. You guys seen the video for this, right? It's actually one of my favorite sets. I haven't taken it apart, but the docks I did take apart because I'm gonna re-brick that. I'll put the link in the description of which one I'm gonna turn it into and we'll see if it's any good. But in the meantime, here it is here. We're going to insult Lego a little bit more by kissing it with another brand, just like that. You know, just looking at it here, you probably can't see it on that monitor or probably like super blurred out and out of focus. But to be brutally honest, kind of looks cool, man. Like, even if I go, I don't know, this way, like this over here. Yeah, pull this back here. What do you guys think? There's the tree, emulating that tree there. Of course, the dock is surrounded by water. I'll pull this back a little bit, how's that? Or maybe you can design it somehow that this can be taken apart and individually put each room on top so you can get some inspiration from this. What do you think? No? Or is it just me? Or am I being silly doing it like this for you guys? I think it looks kind of cool. Yeah, no? Anyway, it's up to you guys. There is your comparison. It's not bad. Overall, it's not bad. Not bad at all. All right, dear. You want to wrap it up for us? Go for it.
You know how much I love you guys. Thanks for watching. We'll be back with the next video. Until next time, break us out. Booyah! Daddy, you forgot me. Oh, man. Nobody's looking. I can pee-pee all I like on this. Where's Scotty at?
Well, Big Scotty's taking forever to get back to our adventures, so we're just chilling and hanging out. Deer is somewhere. Deer, where are you?
I'm right here, Scotty. I wasn't doing anything, I promise. But hey, this place looks kind of cool. Where are we? Why are you dressed like that?
That ninja outfit was bothering me, man. Time to change anyway. This looks much, much better.
Beep, beep. You guys are in a really good restaurant. You should check out the noodles inside. Yes, wonton mein. It's really, really good. Go try it out. I gotta go deliver this food right now. Have fun, guys. Beep, beep.
I don't know, man. Do you trust that guy? I don't see anything good on the menu over here. Zoom, zoom,
zoom. Scotty, stop waving that thing around. It's blocking me. Look, ooh, I see some bunnies there by the window. There's no one there. What if I just take the bun and eat it?
I know it looks really tempting, man, but you know we're not like that. Let's just go inside and find a seat and chill for a little bit.
Okay, sounds good to me.
Hello, is anybody there?
Look at that kitty cat. Why, I gotta. Lucky you're a statue, little cat. I'll kick your ears.
Dear, enough of that. Hey, look, the kitchen's right there. Whoa. Okay, so I don't mean to stare, man, but you know, your head's kind of big. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. We're like a new breed, you know? We have to look a little bit different. So we don't offend other people.
Ah, I see. But anyway, we'd like a table for two, please.
All right, sir. Upstairs, there's a table for two.
Wow, look at all the food on the table. Yummy! Is this for us?
You wish. It is not for you. It is for me. And you're not supposed to be in here, unless you're the one that's being cooked. You know, deer sounds pretty good for a main course.
I'm going now.
Dear, how do we get to the second floor?
Dang it, we gotta jump again. Okay, jump on my back. Get ready. I'm gonna throw you up. 1, 2, 3. That a boy.
Oh, man. Well, that's one way to get up here. Not too bad, not too hurt. Hey, guys, how you doing?
We're on a date right now. And you're kind of in the middle of things. I was just about to ask my date a question, but I don't know if I'm gonna regret it.
Oh man, you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna step out of here, man. She don't look so happy. Good luck with you two. I hope it works out for you guys. Ah, there we go. There's a table. Got some pork buns there. Dear, where is dear? Dear, where you at, dear? Dear?
Why, you little, you better not move. I see you right now, right in front of me. I'm gonna catch you, you little.
What are you doing, man? Food's on the table. You gonna eat or what?
Scotty, you know I gotta get this thing. It's my animal instincts. You know me and kitty cats.
Meow. Wait a minute, are you sure that's a cat? But it looks so pretty. Look, it's smiling at you.
I don't wanna eat it. I just wanna chase it.
Oh, well, in that case, it's all yours, man. Go get it.
Meow. No freaking way. Why does that happen every single time? Dang it.
Dear, let's just go enjoy some food, man. We'll find another cat for you. Don't worry. All right, you guys. Thank you so much. We'll be back sometime. I don't know when. Gotta ask Big Scotty, man. Harass him so we can move on with this adventure. Because you know we got some campers to save. Right, dear? Dear? Dear, now where'd you go?